I am not a builder of buildings. Okay. By the way, I practiced law in the 11th floor. Did you see when Paul Pellegrino showed us the smoke damage? It looks a little different today. Very nice. I am a builder of legal protections for clients, including protections in the field of trademark. And in a moment, I will tell you what a trademark is, and I promise I will tie this back into building design. So trademarks are brand names, names like Ford, and also the logo design for Ford, names like McDonald's, and also the Golden Arches design. But trademarks can be more than just names and logos. I really should have practiced the time. They can be slogans like, just do it. They can be color combinations like the Scotch 3M plaid. They can be sounds like NBC. Anybody know what brand this is? Yeah, thank you. Very good. Bunch of wise guys here tonight. So, what about buildings? Can a building be a trademark? Yes. Buildings can be trademarks. Oh, and so can product designs. This one I registered for my client, Ideal Clamp. Maybe you have an Ideal hose clamp down by your washing machine or some part of your building. So they've come up with this marvelous display rack where they place the hose clamps to sell them in the retail stores. And I registered that product design. So product designs can be protected. And we register our trademarks at the United States Patent and Trademark Office, located in Alexandria, Virginia. And I think it has a very lovely building. And I'm sorry, I don't know who designed it. So yes, buildings can be trademarks. The R circle, by the way, is reserved for registered trademarks. But if you want to claim a trademark and you don't yet have a registration, you can use the TM. That just means you claim a trademark. Clients ask me that every day. So one of the building designs that is protected by a registered trademark is the Empire State Building. And it this particular registration for this design covers observation deck services, parking garage services, cafeteria services, and property services. Now here's another registered trademark. It's registered for motel services. This one flabbergasts me. I am not an architect, but it looks like every single motel I have ever stayed in. This registered trademark belongs to the folks that own Ramada Inns, Hojo, and Wyndham. This is the, you can also register parts of building. This is the facade, or that's probably not the right word. I can get in trouble here. It's the front of the Golden Nugget Casino in Las Vegas. And so that they have chosen to register that part of the building, and this one is registered for hotel services. Anybody know what stadium this is? Yankee Stadium. That's a registered trademark. This particular registration covers coffee mugs, clothing, posters, calendars, and similar items. I had fun looking this up. Who knew? This one absolutely flabbergasted me, too. This is the trading floor of the New York Stock Exchange, and they got a trademark registration for that, for stock exchange services. A person pointed out to me there's human beings in this photo, so I guess they're now part of the registered trademark. The Golden Gate Bridge is a registered trademark for bridge operation services. We could register the Skyway, that would be fun. Or traffic delays. Okay, who knows what one this is? That's a good guess. It's actually the Chicago Art Institute. I love this picture. And it is registered for museum services. So that's part of a building, right? Kind of decoration out front.
Yeah.
I love it. Now, This one is a recycling shed. And it is registered for recycling services. I don't know, I'm not an architect, but I think even I might have been able to design that. I don't know. That's a registered trademark. It's owned by a company in downstate New York. Now, a famous trademark battle took place involving the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame told a photographer who had taken a photo of it and was selling posters to stop, cease and desist, you're violating our trademark. The Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals said, we don't think you have a trademark. So that's a complicated case. Not every court follows it. A lot of people have criticized it. So in conclusion, trademark law can protect building designs. It gets a little complicated. I'm not always sure what exactly the registration covers, but if you have trademark questions, it's a fun area to discuss. And thank you very much.